What's up, folks? Thanks for tuning in again. So we're back here for another lesson, I assume. As promised in the last video, this is the follow-up lesson to one-point perspective, which is two-point perspective. So with that, and no further ado, let me get into the lesson here. So as you may remember from the last video, we used a box or a cube. It was more of a rectangle in retrospect when I look back at it. So we'll just continue on that path here. We'll do the rectangular box with flaps again in two-point perspective, just to illustrate the concept. So again, just like we were doing before, you've got your horizon line, okay? And in this case, the only difference is you're forming a graph with two points, okay? I was gonna go ahead and make something a little more detailed for all perspective points, 1, 2, and 3, a little later on, but I'll kinda just jump into some of these points as tidbits for you to hold on to as you practice and learn. Typically, what I've been taught and what a lot of people will teach you is that you want to keep your points outside of whatever your frame is, your panel, your whatever. In some circumstances, you can use it within the panel if you feel like the angle is necessary. Just keep in mind that, you know, if you box anything up, right? This is just kind of going back on that point. If you box anything up, it's going to be a lot tighter on that perspective point, okay? You have your two points, and I'm just going to form I'm just going to form a panel, kind of give you better perspective as to what I'm trying to illustrate here. And again, we'll do a top-down version of our cardboard box here, whatever, our packaging box. So the idea is you're building up your form in three dimension using two points as opposed to one, okay? Now you have two vanishing points, all right? And as you can see, if I crisscross them, all right, I'm gonna form a grid, if you will. That's a perspective grid. And you can push this close to eye level. That's where your horizontal line is. Okay. You can push them above the eye level or the horizontal line. Okay. Push them up and up and up and up. But if you can kind of grasp what's going on here, this kind of fraying line and grid that's forming makes sense to you, then you can see that with these perspective points just outside of your frame, you're having, I think, for me at least, in my opinion, I think it gives you more of a realistic three-dimensional space to work in, or work within. Let's get back to the lesson. I know I veer a lot here. I'm going to switch to a red brush here to draw the box. Okay. Again, like one-point perspective, your vertical lines, for the most part, okay, unless you really want to dictate otherwise, but for this lesson, let's keep them perfectly straight up and down, just like one-point perspective, okay? And we'll say that all vertical lines that are meant to be straight in this 3D space we're creating are going to be straight up and down, okay? So we'll start right from there. And I'm going to make this area the top of my box, and I make right here the bottom of my box, okay? And I'm going to shift the perspective to the There's a point right there. It's a vanishing point on the horizon line. It's going right to the bottom of the box here, okay? Right here. There's a point we just mentioned going to the top of the box right here, okay? That exact same point at the top, at the bottom, okay, are going over to this, are going over to this vanishing point, and you're now creating the two directions in which your horizontal lines, okay, in your 3D object, which is the box, are receding, okay? This side is going this way, this side is going this way, okay? Alright, I'm not going to draw any horizontal lines like I did in first point perspective, okay, or one point perspective, that are horizontal with my horizon line, okay? None of that. Alright, my horizontal lines are always going to fray to those vanishing points. Alright, I'm going to say this is the end of my box here. And just like we were doing in one point perspective, we're going to bring those lines back to that one point. Okay, right there. X. That's the side of my box, okay? I'm going to put another line right here. That's where my box ends, okay? Or my rectangle. Let's go boom, and let's go boom. What did I do? I just took that point, and I threaded them right back to this guy, okay? There we go. There you go. Now you have your box in 3D space, receding where it may, correctly, using two-point perspective, okay? We trace it out for you, show you how it has form, show you how it looks, and we take away all the grid, all right? Connect all these dots here, bring all our points together. Remember, all these horizontal lines, they're all fraying to the correct spot there in space. And you're left with a box, okay? So I want to make it look like it's hollow inside. There we go. Alright? And honestly, I won't drag on today's lesson beyond that point, you know? Here is an example of how you might use two-point perspective from that same perspective point. Actually, you know what? For sake of what we're doing here. So this thing is about 20 yards in front of us, okay? I said before, we're using vertical lines. We use vertical lines, okay? I'm gonna freehand car my best ability for you. We'll do a van, okay? Easy enough. Boxy, easy enough. All right. I'm gonna just kind of sketch it out. I'm not gonna go too crazy with the entire anatomy of it. Okay. Just assume that. So what have I drawn already? I've drawn a box, right? I've drawn that same box we drew before. It's literally right here. Right? There you go. There's our box. Let's keep drawing our van, okay? So this is the grill. It's coming out like so. This is going to be a very boxy car, just so we have a simplistic example. Alright, every one of these horizontal lines I'm drawing, okay, they're doing exactly what I told you they were doing in the last example, which is they recede to those points, and I'm using this grid to guess those lines as I draw in the shape of the van, okay? So we'll say, and there's tricks I'm doing here, there's a little bit of cheating I'm doing here, okay? So if you do try to attempt this yourself, note there's a reason why things may not perfectly be coming out the right way, why it may not look exactly how mine does. Okay, keep in mind, all these vertical lines, other than the ones that I'm deciding I want to fray out, because really, if we look at the front of a van, it kind of looks like that, right? Or whatever, this type of van. It's going to have more of a, you know, pretty sharp angle, and then it dips, right? So, again, you can see we're starting to get some form here. Let's pretend there's a mirror here. Other side. Okay. Where would that be on the other side? Let's draw it back. Let's try to figure it out. It's about yay away from the car here. It's tucked, okay. Our overlap here is going to tuck away that. But if we draw through, it's right about there. And then, boom, we got a mirror. Okay. Okay, I'm trying to draw this van as quick as possible. We'll say that the hood there. That plate, we'll say that last tire's in the back here, like so. Alright. You get the idea, right? And you can go as far as pulling your axle on the same line, okay? That center point and that center point are going to line up, and they're both going towards that perspective point. This one's going back here, like this one's going back here, okay? That's our axle, right there, and right there. That's what you're going to build your tires off of, you know? And you can, you know, when you get good at it, you can freehand them. For now, you can just use, you can use a box to kind of shape in those tires and figure out where they're going to go in space here, okay? Just like that. Figure it out from there. You say that's the bottom. So, just figure it out. How it goes. One tire. See? And everything I'm drawing here, it's all receding back to those lines. Whether it's like a round shape, or a boxier one with a sharper angle on it. Anyway, I don't want to digress from the lesson too much and overcomplicate things, but that's the gist of it, you know, and you can go from there and detail everything, you know, level things out. Like I was saying in the last video, you can use silhouettes to kind of maybe, like, let's say you're referencing this van from a photo, and that van has a very particular, you know, shape to it. You can reference that into perspective and then guide everything else from that point, you know what I mean? Anyway,
tune in soon. I'll have a three-point perspective, and then I'll do an overview where I can show you how this stuff applies to something a little more complicated. Okie dokie. Have a nice day. Thanks for stopping by. If you like what you're seeing, you can subscribe, like, comment, so I know what you're thinking out there, if these are even helping you. Okay? Have a good day.